Amon's forces arrived here before we did. The temple may already be under his control.
Zeratul believed the other xel'naga were here, and that they would stand with us against Amon. They could end the war. My people could be free once again.
Then why have the xel'naga not answered us?
I am going into the Ulnar Temple alone, Matriarch. I do not intend to risk any more lives.
You risked your own life on the word of a traitor.
He killed your mother, Vorazun. That is true. But he was never a traitor. I do not wish for death. Only to see Zeratul's visions fulfilled.
You will return. That much, I believe.
My warriors cannot aid me in the battle ahead. This burden is mine to bear.
The starfighters have arrived, and they await your evaluation.
The skies await.
It is a good day to die.
These purifiers have joined our army, Hierarch. It seems they are willing to serve you. For now.
Where shall we march?
I am returned.
Where shall we march?
Since we arrived here, the keystone has reacted strangely. It's as if it is attuned to the energies below.
Energies below?
Yes. Void energies exude from this place. I believe this world is a conduit between dimensions.
And the keystone?
Acts as if siphoning these energies. This is entirely different from how the origin point information was stored. As if the keystone was reconfigured for a second purpose.
Let us hope that the xel'naga themselves can reveal the truths you're looking for.
There is still much to be done.
Vorazun, I know not what I shall find below, but I know I must go alone. You are in command of the Spear of Adun now.
Until you return, Artanis.
I have come seeking the xel'naga.
Follow me.
seems fate has drawn us together. We should not tempt it further. Call this place the Temple of Unification. The xel'naga are somewhere within.
So far, all I've encountered are hybrid. I've been fighting them for days. Progress has been difficult.
The prophecies foretell of two ascended races working together to seek out the halls of revelation within the temple. Only with both present will the shrines reveal the means to awaken the slumbering xel'naga.
I've never cared much for prophecy.
And yet, despite our history, here we stand, together. Perhaps you should start. Harak and Vyash. There can be... Let us make for the shrine. Together, we are strong. It seems the temple has guardians. I will deal with them. A bold plan. Halt! Do you sense that? A great power awakens within this construct.
Purity of form. Purity of essence. Prove your strength.
Your queen listens, so the constructs hold the keys. Good to know.
Let us proceed. Dawn will come. Our path is clear. These devices emit solar energy. We should gather them.
Our knowledge is your heritage.
There can be no doubt.
Look out! Hybrid!
I lead.
You have my attention.
Change is upon us. Our path is clear. Together.
Another construct. We'll have to destroy it to open the doorway.
We shall prevail.
Explain yourself.
Our destiny awaits. There can be no doubt. A key is still missing. There's a powerful energy across this chasm. Kerrigan, remain here. I must investigate this. Dawn will come. Kerrigan, the construct is coming for you! A bold plan. Strength in unity.
Your queen.
We shall prevail. There can be no doubt. The future is ours.
Explain yourself.
Dawn will come. With honor, I lead. A bold plan. Mother's power. It should be active shortly.
Friends of yours?
Not quite. It appears Amon's forces have found a way into the temple. We must slay them all.
I think I'm starting to like you, Artanis. Your queen listens. What is it already? Speak.
Dawn will come.
Let's finish this. Then we can see what your shrine has to say.
I see now. The xel'naga were the first, born within the void. Their sacred purpose was to cultivate life and perpetuate the infinite cycle. At a new universe's creation, they take a physical form. If destroyed, thrust back into the void. All of this time, they have waited for us to assemble the keystone and find our way here. Amon indwells my people, possessing them through the collar, but he has no physical form. If he were separated from the temple, he could be forced back into the void.
Come on, Artanis. We've still got a long way to go.
Strength in unity.
Let's go. It won't be long until our enemy pushes further into the temple.
It seems you were correct.
Well then, shall we? What is it already? My search continues. Speak. No time like the present.
Strength in unity. Find another way forward. We are strong. It appears the Tal'Darim are preoccupied. We should engage them while they are fighting the constructs.
I've come this far.
Dawn will come.
Make it quick. I am the Swarm.
Harak and Vyash. The future is ours. A bold plan.
What fools you are to attack me. Yes?
Change is upon us. With honor, I lead. This passage has caved in as well. Wait. Hybrid. The future is ours. Our path is clear.
Ulnar shall serve as your tool.
You have my attention.
We shall prevail. Together, we are strong.
Our heritage is your future.
With honor, I lead.
They're fighting another construct.
No doubt. A bold plan. Our path is clear. Clear.
Looks like we've earned a breather. You're up, Artanis. The shrines look like they're covered with pictograms. How do you know what they say?
Communing with the shrine is more than reading carvings. Each atom of the stone has been placed with meaning, purpose. Assembly of races in other universes. Every time, they observe and identify the potential of their offspring, never interfering. The infinite cycle will always be the same. Two races are destined to emerge. One, pure of essence, an indomitable spirit capable of great change, and one, pure of form. A being capable of vast psionic potential, able to house the essence of a xel'naga. Purity of essence and form, the Zerg and the Protoss. But if the xel'naga do not interfere, then it was uplifted my people. All we thought was the xel'naga. Was a lie.
Come on, Artanis. We're not far from having some answers.
I believe this must be the final hall.
Wait. The doors are open. The construct's destroyed.
The shrine is under attack. This can only be the work of Aeon. We delay no longer. Our salvation will not be stolen from us. Harak and Vyash. Together, we are...
Let's get to that shrine.
The future is ours. There can be no doubt. Our path is clear.
Make it quick.
We shall prevail. There can be no doubt. A bold plan. Bold plan. Together, we are strong. With honor, I lead. The future is ours. There can be no doubt.
By blood and fire, we shall be reborn.
These people are maniacs.
A bold plan.
Your queen listens.
Our destiny awaits.
You have my attention.
Harak and Vyash. Strength in unity. Together, we are strong.
Push them unto the infinite abyss.
Dawn will come.
Speak.
Change is upon us. There can be no doubt. Together, we are strong. A bold plan. The future is ours. Our path is clear.
Our future is as one in the void.
I lead.
Speak.
Our destiny awaits us. For Zeratul, for Aya!
Only darkness awaits.
Make it quick.
I serve my people. We shall prevail.
Speak. What is it already?
Dawn will come.
It's done. Do your shrine thing, Artanis. These gods of yours have a lot to answer for.
Ahead of us, within the Chamber of Ascension, the xel'naga have slumbered as civilizations grew, fell, and formed again. They will awaken when the two destined races arrive. Then, the elders among them will give their lives to bestow their essence. And pure of form and pure of essence will be reborn as xel'naga, shepherds of the infinite cycle.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do you say? Ready to get your maker? Something's not right here.
Xel'naga. No.
They're dead, Artanis.
So easily broken, Amon. The firstborn shall fear you no longer!
Matriarch, there is a massive output of void energy spiking from the temple below.
Target the epicenter.
Listen to me, Matriarch. Amon's trap is sprung. Your leader is in grave danger.
You think us fools?
Yes, but that is irrelevant. What is relevant is that Amon has opened a gateway to the void. Dark energies pour from within, and they will burn through your precious leader and any who oppose Amon. I can guide you to Artanis before this fate befalls him. If we are bold, we can stop the Dark God's assault.
Am I to believe that the moment you're released, your blade will not be in my back?
You waste time.
Lower your blades. I am Alarak, first descendant of the Tal'Darine. Amon has betrayed my people. Retribution will be claimed for this, and if your hierarch survives, he will aid in it. Make your decision.
You will take us to Artanis.
Most wise.
I have brought an additional defensive ability online, Matriarch. Please visit the Solar Core to configure it.
the Xel'naga's failure.
Let her go!
I offer a gift. Release in oblivion.
Silence! This Tal'Darim has brought warriors with him. Perhaps there is a benefit to his presence after all.
Where does my prey hide? Matriarch, the Keystone has begun absorbing void energies at an unprecedented rate.
Then this Tal'Darim speaks the truth.
Void energies flood from the temple. With each passing moment, the threat grows. I do not trust him, but all data points to the scenario he describes. A gateway to the void has been opened.
Is there any way to pinpoint Artanis?
No. The energies are making us virtually blind.
We must put our faith in this Tal'Darim. It pains me to do so.
Your Hierarch is apparently unaware of the danger closing in around him. If you desire his safe return, you will send your warriors to these coordinates now. This path will lead your forces to Artanis. I have done as I promised, Dark Templar. Now go tell your Hierarch. I am waiting for him.
Matriarch, our High Templar have volunteered to aid you.
The loss of the Kala was not easily borne, but we are ready to serve once again.
Templar, I thank you for your bravery in this dire time. We will recover our Hierarch.
Storms, brothers. Let these hybrid thralls feel the wrath of the Templar.
Protoss! Coming!
I will comply. Heard of these Terran specters. Focus their energies into a feedback loop. They will not bear it. I will comply. Antaro Tassadar. Olak Natar.
Templar, join us, quickly!
To me, my swarm!
Vorazun, your forces have arrived just in time. Amon has opened a portal to the void. It must be shut down before it tears us apart.
Agreed. My swarm and I will bear the brunt of Amon's power. and buy you time. But it's up to you to seal that portal.
The gateway draws power from these void crystals. We will need to destroy them if we are to seal the gate.
Then it shall be done.
The darkness is approaching my hive cluster, Artanis. I hope you're getting ready to disable those crystals. I'll continue sending as many Zerg as I can spare to help you. Fight well, Templar.
As ever, I serve.
The crystal's defenders have fallen. Move in and destroy it.
Hierarch, I am detecting several energy sources hidden across the temple. They appear to be xel'naga vessels, ancient power sources. If we can locate them, I should be able to use their energy to free up additional solarite from the Spear of Adun's core. Crystal destroyed. Sensors are showing three more remain, Hierarch.
I will comply.
Yes. Anderson, slay these heretics in Aemon's name! We meet the enemy in battle! Your thoughts are clear.
My swarm moves against the crystal. Join us, Artanis.
Crystal is secure. Destroy it as soon as possible.
Our spirit is indomitable.
Two crystals destroyed. I suspect Aemon's forces will not let us take the next two so easily.
Hybrid are moving to attack our nexus point. Ready our defenses.
Thank you. warrior awakens.
You have not enough minerals.
It's high time I dealt with this personally. Minions, to the void crystal.
Free of defenders. Our warriors can destroy it whenever you are ready.
This war we meet the enemy in battle with honor. Kassad de Deflari.
Only one remains, and the portal is growing unstable. We must destroy the final crystal, and do so with haste.
Enough, my swarm. Pull back. We'll regenerate at the Hive Cluster.
Hybrid inbound on our nexus point. Warriors, intercept them.
Phoenix! Executed.
Artanis, hurry up and disable those void crystals. My Hive Cluster is taking a beating.
Speak your demands. With honor. Shall be purified. With honor, Ulas Atari. My blade yearns to meet our foe.
We've secured a xel'naga vessel, Karax. Prepare for transfer.
Unbelievable. Despite eons of inactivity, these devices are still at full power.
Minions, push forward. Engage Amon's forces. Artanis, now's a good time to make your move.
My charge?
The second xel'naga power source has been secured. I only detect one energy signal left.
My charge. Unity through purpose.
Listening. Protocols aligned.
It is a good day to die.
What guidance?
Kassar into blood.
We meet the enemy in blood.
My brood is pushing towards a crystal.
I stand.
Warriors, hold back from the shadow tendril. It will only consume you.
Torridas!
We fought well this day, Kerrigan. Join us. Together, we can defeat Amon and send him back into the void.
My swarm was broken here, Artanis. I'll need time to rebuild my forces.
There is no time. My people are being consumed. Their very flesh turned into Amon's own. I cannot wait.
Then you must do as I have. Gather allies, subjugate enemies, do whatever you can to ensure victory. Survival is never pretty.
We are very different leaders, but I thank you nonetheless. Until we meet again.
Artanis, Hierarch of the Twilight Council, Warlord of the Templar. I had expected so much more.
Arrogance! Watch your words, or my blade will watch them for you.
Oh, that's hardly a way to speak of one who saved your master's life.
You care little for my survival, Alarak. What is the true reason you've come to me?
Our god broke his ancient covenant and cast us low.
These are lies, Artanis.
I am the liar. Are you not but a lie incarnate machine, Protoss?
Speak your peace, Alarak.
The Tal'Darim's death fleet amasses its slain, awaiting the start of a full-scale invasion. I come with an offer. You will aid me in invoking a challenge for the right to rule my kind as High Lord. And in return, I will grant you a cessation of hostilities between our people.
Phoenix, rally my advisors. It appears we have much to discuss.
Ah, Artanis. I believe I will serve you more effectively from here. Besides, I would rather Alarak remain where he can be watched.
Nothing was as it seemed. We came to Ulnar to awaken the xel'naga and receive their aid. Instead, Amon nearly killed us. I fear Zeratul's prophecy is no longer clear to me.
He was closer to the truth than I thought. The xel'naga did rest here. Had they lived, I think they would have given us their aid, just as Zeratul said. If nothing else, I will grant him that.
Matriarch, your words surprise me.
Perhaps your council has proved influential in some regards.
Then I will endeavor to give you more of it.
I said some regards, Hierarch. Not all.
Rohanna, do you not see why you must sever your nerve cords? I cannot allow you to fall under Amon's sway again.
The collar was created in our darkest moment. Only its light was able to bind our people, to give us unity. We are born into it, and when we die, our spirits become one with it. It is worth fighting for.
And now Amon uses it against us. It sustains his existence. Its time must end.
Artanis, through the Kala, our every thought and emotion are made as one. I feel his thoughts and emotions swirling like a vortex throughout. He does not realize it, but here, within the Kala, he is vulnerable.
How?
Just as he can see into me, I can see into him. We can use this to our advantage, Hierarch. I know it.
It is not worth it.
Please, I only ask for time. Powerful psionic warriors have joined our ranks, Hierarch. You must choose among them.
Order me to war.
Cassar de Templari.
Energy.
believe I have found a way to save our people. As Zeratul foresaw, this keystone can indeed be our salvation.
Explain yourself.
As we have seen, the keystone was designed to be found and assembled by those who would ascend to become xel'naga. After leading them to Ulnar, it would also expel its stored energy to awaken the slumbering xel'naga. The keystone siphons energies and redistributes essence, matter, information, consciousness. To this device, they are all the same. I see that now.
This is how it cleansed Kerrigan?
It extracted the essence that forged her into the Queen of Blades. Then it used that energy to release Amon from the void. If I can discover how to control the keystone, we could use it to extract Amon from the Kala and save our people.
Then Zeratul has led us to hope after all. Continue your research, Kerax. We have a war to take to Amon.
You were right all along, Hierarch. I am little more than a clone of your friend, Phoenix. The Tal'Darim speaks truth. I am synthetic, a replication, a lie.
What did you find in the archive?
My death, my rebirth as a Dragoon, and then my death at the hands of this Queen of Blades. I am not Phoenix, yet I hold his memories as if they were my own. I must have time to consider this.
You are a warrior, Phoenix. Whether you identify yourself as my old friend or not, know that I believe in you. And I believe you will help me destroy Amon's armies and save our people. Do not waver because of this knowledge.
I will try, Hierarch.
You must know Amon will destroy you.
If you have such faith in him, why are you here?
Oh, I merely voice the inevitable. I know the true power of what you face. I said destroy you, not I.
I have seen enough. His hubris will be his undoing. It is a flaw I also see in you.
I believe I like you, Hierarch. Your bravery is commendable.
Join me then. Together, we can defeat him.
I cannot tether my fate to yours. Hatred does not burn within you as it does in me. You do not see through the agony of knowing all you believed in is a lie, and that your only solace is found in the destruction of your betrayer.
No. Amon corrupted my people, and now turns them into a hybrid abomination. My rage burns brighter than 1,000 suns, and soon all will see my wrath unleashed.
Then this is something I hope to witness.